It costs $0 to make this ecosystem. Let me introduce you the ecotone. I used pebbles from the river and a bunch of slabs because I wanted to make it both terrestrial and aquatic ecosystem. From here on, all you will see added to the aquarium was taken from the wild in my area. I don't want any escape to become an invasive species. But I don't want an aquarium, I want an ecosystem. So it needs to have all the levels in the food chain. Let's start from the beginning. The producers. Three different types of moss. Two types of ferns, stone crops, aquatic moss, fool's watercress, and a bunch of duckweeds. Producers, check. Next level, primary consumers. But I don't want them to eat my plants, so I choose to use animals that eat only dying plants. Water snails, two different species. Copepods, they look funny until you switch off the microscope and you realize they are too small. But they are an important natural filter for the water. Primary consumers, check. No, wait, we need some consumers in the terrestrial environment as well. Let's add some isopods. They will eat any dead plant. Primary consumers, check. Decomposes. This is dirty water from a pond. It's full of bacteria and fungi. Nothing too exciting, but enough to keep the ecosystem balanced. So yeah, decomposes, check. For me, this aquarium is already working, and I'm having such a good time just watching the snails roaming around. But after 2 weeks, I realized we have a problem here. All these animals you're seeing? Mosquitoes. It wasn't my plan, but I created the perfect mosquito farm. And I don't want this inside my home. We have to find a solution. We need to add the apex predator. And I choose water scorpions. Why? They look cool. Also, they can breathe air. They can leave the water and hunt some isopods as well. So they'll help to control all the populations, but the snails, I don't think they can do anything against the snails. I just added them and they are already eating some mosquito larvae, so it's a success. Okay, a short break. It's taking me forever to edit this video, so please let me know if you're liking the video by interacting with it or subscribing to my channel, and I'm not wasting more of your time, so let's continue with the video. The ecotone is now thriving and I shouldn't need to add any food to it. A perfect balance emerged from all the complex interactions between all the species in the aquarium, and from now on, my role is the silent spectator.